Amber?
Yes?
Where are you?
In the office doing my education math class.
Right now, I am working full-time. I am going to college full-time. I am a full-time mom and a part-time wife.
How is work?
Still slow. Since I've left the college and I'm no longer in the landscape industry, I have really been enjoying selling cars. My only regret is I wish that I had done it earlier. Let me help you.
No. My birthday is coming up, and we are going to have family dinner. And, you know, we have texted the big kids, letting them know, you know, come to the house.
Have you heard from Jonah?
No, I have texted him, but I have not gotten any response. And I can't see him on the locator, so.
No location found. We have had the family locator for 5 years, maybe. Once the big kids started driving, it is a peace of mind and it is reassurance to see they made it to school or we're not home and they made it back home safely.
Since his escapade, it really concerns me to not be able to see him on the locator because that was a time that we really could have stepped in a lot quicker if we would have seen him on the locator.
We definitely had a big incident go down where we had to help him out after he had, you know, taken some Delta 8.
Me and a couple of friends heard about this sort of substance called Delta 8.
Delta 8 is a chemical compound that is derived from like hemp and cannabis. It's illegal here in Georgia and it is not regulated.
We all hit like a paranoia stage as to, you know, what's really going on.
You don't remember the phone conversation.
You kept asking, where are you? I need to know where you're at.
You were scared. You were scared. You didn't know where I was going. You was upset. Couldn't tell me where you was at. Wanted me to come get you.
Since then, he's really not been very present when he is here. It's just a different Jonah.
And since that day, there's no other way to say it that Amber and I, at times, have had some PTSD. I've texted him just to try to say, like, hey, what you up to? Are you good?
No response.
He's just not responded.
As it stands right now, Jonah hasn't responded to some of our texts. We don't want to jump to any conclusions. We want to give him the benefit of the doubt, see if he shows up at our birthday dinner. Hopefully he will. And it's just, you know, Trent and I being a little more cautious or overprotective than before, but we just don't know.
We'll just have to wait and see if he shows up.
Tonight, we are all getting together, the whole family, to celebrate Amber's 43rd birthday. Does mom look older?
No.
No, she looks the same. When you turn 50, I don't know.
I mean, we'll see it gradually, so maybe we won't see it.
Well, it depends on how hard you are on me.
True. Emma and I are both about to wrap up our sophomore year of high school. I'm about to turn 17. I'm just ready to get sophomore year over.
I've been pretty much focusing on finishing my sophomore year, heading to my junior year, and hopefully I'll find something that I will enjoy doing for my like career.
Are we waiting for the girls to get here?
Yeah.
And Jonah?
Yep.
I asked Anna and Elizabeth if they would stop by and pick up some dinner so mom doesn't have to cook.
Knock, knock.
Hello. Yes?
First birthday, girl.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Are y'all the birthday surprise or the...
Yes, gift? And we actually need your to help with food.
Currently, I am working a full-time job as a dialysis tech. Bryce and I have been dating for over 3 years now. I still love him like crazy. I cannot wait to see, you know, where life takes us even more. And I'm still in nursing school. I have about one more year left until I graduate. Definitely counting down the days until I become a nurse.
Trent, did you text Jonah?
Yes. Yeah, that was fun.
Well, do we want to go ahead and fix plates?
Yes. I've been messaging Jonah and texting, trying to figure out where he's at. No messages were answered, and it's frustrating. I just wanted everybody to be here. Jonah knew clearly what time to be home.
I can't see him on location.
Well, I can't either, so.
Half the time, his phone's dead.
Or asleep.
Or it's asleep, yeah, exactly.
When the event with Delta 8 and Jonah happened, I did not know what he took at that time. I just knew mom and dad were worried that we weren't able to find him.
He's our brother.
him going through something so traumatic like this, it's scary.
We know kids and teenagers can be stupid and stuff, but like we never would have expected Jonah just to do something like this. And that was the biggest thing that like just kind of got to me and Anna was like, why would he want to do this?
It could have turned out way worse. And luckily it didn't. Thank God it didn't, but it could have turned out so much worse.
This is good, girls.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Very good.
Thank you.
Slaved over it all day.
Mm-hmm.
If that's the case, then tell us how you cooked it.
Yeah. Not this roast.
Pork chops.
Pork chops?
You know, roast, pork chops, same thing.
Same thing.
Let's hit the pause button real quick. What animal does this come from?
Oh, a pig.
What animal does the roast come from?
Oh, I know this one.
Oh, a rooster.
Can't make it up. In the South, we just say, bless your heart.
Don't
chair.
Sorry, I know I'm late, but I just completely lost track of time. Since the incident with Delta 8, work's not going well at all. I'm living with my friend, and that's going okay. Ashley and I have been dating a little over 3 years. Where me and Ashley are, it definitely could be better. All the situations, I think, could be better.
Is your phone dead?
No, my phone wasn't dead. I just haven't checked it.
Definitely concerned with Jonah showing up late and just kind of distant about it. The fact that, you know, he doesn't respond to text messages. And that's frequently. That's not just tonight.
Happy birthday. I can definitely tell my dad is very annoyed right now. My mom is definitely hiding it, but she's also annoyed as well. I could just tell the vibe is a little off.
What'd you do today, Jonah?
Went to work, and then just about it. Came home and chilled. I had a mind that it was mom's birthday. I just lost track of time.
I was texting you nonstop.
You must be the only 22-year-old never to check your phone. Why aren't you checking your phone?
I know it's not normal for people my age, but you know, I just don't have a big enough priority like I should do, check my phone.
I'm not gonna fuss about it.
It's mama's birthday.
Y'all wanna do some cake and ice cream now?
That's fine.
The fact that I was late hurt my mom's feelings, but I know it affected my dad a lot more because he expected me to show up on time.
Gotcha. 43.
It's always great to have all of the kids home and all of us around the same table.
Given the circumstances right now where we're at with Jonah and his understanding mom, it was still good to see Jonah.
Do you need this to go in the fridge?
No, before they all come back in here. There are some things, and sometimes you have to make priorities. You knew what we had going on. You knew what time to be here.
Right.
There's distractions or something going on. We got to get it figured out. Right now, we don't really have an idea of what's going on with Jonah. He's 22 years old. He does not live in our home. But we still have a right to be concerned. You and I are just going to have a sit down. Talk. We ain't going to do it tonight at the birthday party. We let all the big kids live their independent lives and do things. But when we see things that are not healthy and are not good, we step in. I'll do this. Go in there and hang out with mom and them, and I'll get this stuff. It's going to take some time. We got to figure out what's going on. There are some problems.